Hey, what's going on? I'm Styler, and in this video I will review the Fork N4 that I ordered on efoxshop.com. For more specs and info, check out the video description. So this phone comes with a 5.7-inch HD screen, support for USB on the go, 4D air gestures, dual microphones, and Android 4.4.2 KitKat out of the box. Inside we also find the MTK6592 octa-core clocked at 1.7GHz, 1GB RAM, 16GB ROM, and an advanced S Pen with working button and dot. So to make this video shorter, we will jump right to the test. If you want to check the phone design in details, please go and check my full unboxing video, you find it on my channel. So let me just do a quick 360 degree of the phone so you just can see how it looks. And you notice it's the white version, all white, only the black screen on the front is very dark and black. Actually, it's a little bit curved here in the edge, and the same here in the other side here, and in the top and the bottom. And some manufacturers call this 2.5D because if it was 3D it would be even more curved, but on this one here it's only a little bit curved, so you can actually maybe see it here. So let us turn it on, and here you see the lock screen. So we have here a shortcut directly to go to the camera, like we know it from Samsung devices. Okay, so let us just unlock the screen here. So what you see here is the home screen. We have here the UI, and it reminds us of the Samsung TouchWiz because we see here the typical Samsung icons. And let's just have a look here inside the UI here. Let's try out to test the speed here, and you can see it's pretty snappy and fast. Let's go back, let's try here also. And we also will find apps like the Walking Mate, Food Tracker and so on. We also have the heart rate sensor on the back and the app, so it clearly tries to copy everything from the Samsung Galaxy Note 4. And let us also check out the viewing angles. So you can see the viewing angle is okay, I would say. Not bad. Let's try from the top. You can see. You can clearly see the text also and read it. You can see the icons really good. So the colors are actually pretty vivid and good on this phone here, but the resolution is only HD, and when you go really close up with the phone, you will actually notice the pixels in the icons. So that's because it's not a full HD, and I would clearly have recommended a full HD screen for this phone here, because the HD is simply just too small a resolution for such a big screen. And let us also have a closer look here on the buttons. You see we have here clear white light in menu, home and back. Off-screen gestures, so just let me show you here, double tap. You double tap here to wake, yeah. And you can, for example, draw an V to open up the dialer. You can draw an O to start up the camera app, see it here. And the phone also support air gestures, so I can do like this to change the pace, and also back again, so in both directions here. And we can also go from top and down, and from down and up again. So that's the 4D air gestures that you just saw here. And let's have a look here. In the top we have here the quick toggles. And some of these are actually fake, because we will also find stuff like, for example, S-Beam and NFC. And of course this phone here has no NFC built in, so this is just fake. And also the smart scroll here, I wasn't able to get this working, so I think this is also just fake. And let's try to have a look here on all. Okay, let us have here a look on the Wi-Fi reception, and you can see it's actually in top. So the Wi-Fi is really, really good. We also see here the network connection is about 80 to 90%, so that's also pretty good. Okay, so here I have activated the mobile data 3G, and we see here H plus speed. So sometimes it will switch to just H. It's working fine on this phone. So let me also show you here the side panel here. We have these shortcuts, and these are for the home and back, and the task manager you can hold here, and you can move this around. So this is called side panel, I think. We can try to, for example, click here. And what you see here is the task manager overview, but this is not Android 5. Actually, it's just a copy of the task manager. Pretty nice. Okay. And actually, we also have another side panel here. And it's called a multi-window in the settings, but it's not real multi-window, because actually it will just open up one app at a time. So for example, I open up the gallery. I can open up, for example, settings, but it will just switch around. You can't actually open up two. I have tried to slide out here, but you can see it doesn't really work that way. So when I click, it just switches the whole page. So I would not call this real multi-window, just a sidebar with some shortcuts. Okay, so let us try to compare here the Fork N4 here with another phone, and what we here have is the Lanvo L600S. Let's see here. They also both have metal in the side, but the back side is a whole other story here on the Lanvo. You see this is aluminium here, really metal here on the back, while here on the Fork N4 we of course just have this plastic back. And also you see the cameras are all different, so only here on the front they are very similar in my opinion. Let's now have a look here on the settings. And here you see all the quick settings here in the top. You can add more here also. We have here, of course, SIM management, because it's dual SIM. We have all the normal settings like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and so on, airplane mode. Let's have a look here in display. So here you can see the side panel. You can enable or disable it here. We have the LED indicator. So here you can set it to flash when the battery gets low, for example. We have the font size. Let's go back again. We also see multi-window and motion. So here in motion you can enable gesture, air browse, air launcher and so on. We also here have motion activation, so you can shake to update. You can make direct calls when you put the phone up to the ear, when you're inside the contacts. Turn over to mute. So here inside you can set up the off-screen gestures, draw and V to go to the phone, for example, O for camera and so on, and also here the double tap. So here we have some options for the S Pen. So for example here, show the pointer, or you can set here what the S Pen should do when you pull out the pen. You can change the sound. Let's have a look here in language. And also very important here, the storage. So let's see what we have here. We have internal 4 GB for the apps. We have here the phone storage, about 10 GB. And I guess the rest will be for the cache and the ROM. Here you can also see you can mount SD card. It supports micro SD cards. We have options for power saving, security. Let's just have a look here in about. You can also see here, here we have the applications. Okay, about. So here we see something called system updates and wireless updates. Let's just have a look inside. So yeah, it will say the system is up to date. And actually the same here in wireless update. We also see here a build number. If this is going to work, I don't know, because we are talking here about a clone. Okay, we see here the model number, Android version is KitKat. The build number, let's just check here the Android version. See KitKat here. Android version 4.4.2. So that's it for the settings. Okay, let us have a look here inside the camera app. So you see here the app, and we have different options here. Let's go into the settings. Let's just scroll through these, because many of these are just stock. We have 0 shutter delay, face detection, picture size, but this would be interpolated 30 megapixels. We have preview size, full screen or standard. We have here for recording videos, and we find here time-lapse interval, video quality. Let's have a look here on mode. So here you will find beauty face, panorama, and so on. Okay, so let me just try here a picture. And you can see the autofocus is also working perfectly fine. Okay, let's just zoom a little bit, and you can see the quality is actually pretty nice. It's okay here. We see all the details. Let's try here the text. So of course the camera doesn't match what you find on the original Note 4, but it's okay. I would say it's not that bad. And for camera samples in full resolution, I will provide some samples in the video description, so don't forget to check these out. Okay, so here we see the front-facing camera. And actually, you see the text here, so you can use this for nice selfies. I would say the quality is okay. Let's check out the flashlight to see how the LED is. And I must say the LED on this phone here is really weak. It's not strong at all. You can see here, you barely see it. So yeah, you can use this as a low torch, but for pictures, not recommended. Let us also have a look here on S health. So here you have like on the Samsung Note 4 and Note 3, for example, we have a pedometer or heart rate. Let's check out the heart rate. And you have to put the finger here on the sensor on the back. And I already tried it one time here and got 69 beats per minute. But I do doubt that it actually works. It could also just be fake, because these values happen to change each time you try it actually, so I don't think it's real. Another app is the remote app here, the IR Blaster. And on my Samsung television, this app here actually works pretty good. It found my TV immediately, and I can use the remote app here, about 5 to 6 meters away. So it's actually working good with my Samsung, and it's also fast. When I click one time on the channel, it reacts immediately. And I was a little bit surprised because I didn't expect too much from this remote app, but it's working as good as on my original HTC One or, for example, my LG G3. So I don't have anything bad to say about this app. So we also find this video player, and let me just try to start it up here. And let's start over. So this is just a commercial for the phone here, and it also support here video pop out. So you click here, and actually this is a layer on top. You can see I can move it around. I can resize, I think, here a little bit. Okay, and let's move it up here. You can see, move it around. Let's go to the start. Let us now test out the S Pen here, and as soon you pull it out, you get here the air command, and we also find here on the S Pen a button, and the button actually works on this one here. You will also see when I go close here a small dot. So I actually don't touch the screen here right now with the S Pen. I just hover over the screen here, and the small dot here is displayed, and I can also click here to close the air command and click again to open it up, and all this is done without touching the screen at all. Of course I can touch it. Now I'm touching the screen here. I can click here, I can click on the button. So this is working almost like on the original Note 4. And it's a pretty nice feature. Let's just try to go inside here. But I must admit that the S Pen here is of course not that fast and precise as the original on the Note 4. Because when I draw, let's just try, you see there is a small delay when I draw the line here, you see. But you can use it, and you can see here, you can actually draw with it, so it does work. But the one thing, it's very sensitive to dust or dirt on the display, so if you have fingerprints on the glass and you use it, it may not always work that good. So always keep the screen clean when you're using the S Pen, and it will actually work okay. Okay, so now to a USB on the go test, OTG cable here with a USB stick, and let me just connect it here to see if it's found or not. Yeah, and we see it's found as external USB storage. Say cancel here, and let's go into my files. So let me see, we have here actually now the USB stick. Let's check out pictures. So this is working good, you can see. These are loaded off here, the USB stick, and let's try out some music also. Okay, so the sound here is coming out the Inatec Bluetooth speaker here. I connected the phone with the Bluetooth, so let's just try to turn it off. Okay, so this is working really good. So some few words regarding using headphones. The sound quality and bass is pretty good with Player Pro, for example. Only the volume is what I would call average, because it could be louder in my opinion, but it is also not totally low, so it's okay. Okay, let us try a test call. So here you see the proximity sensor is working.
Zero new messages. One saved messages. To listen to today's messages, press one. To change your personal option,
press two. Zero new messages. One saved messages. To listen to today's messages.
So some info here about the battery. The battery here on the phone here is not identical to what we find on the original Note 4 from Samsung. Actually, you can't fit such a battery inside the phone. You see, it doesn't go in, and you see here, it's not possible. And actually here, in top here, this looks different here on the Note 4, because we see here, on this one here, actually it's a hole here, while on this one here it's not a hole, it's a tap. So it's a little bit different here. And also here, the back cover here, you can fit this back cover here on top. Let's just try, but it doesn't look that good, because the camera on the Fog N4 is round, while on the Note 4 you see it's not round, it's square. So that's a big difference here, but it's possible to fit the cover, but just looks a little bit funny here, I would say. Now I'm going to run some different test apps and a game. I will turn up for the background music, so let's get to it. Thank you. So we are now in the end of this review, and I will now list some of the pros and cons. So first to the pros, it has an advanced S Pen with a real working button and a dot on the screen. It also offers dual SIM and a real IR blaster that works really good. It has a very nice phone design, especially the front looks stunning and the screen is very dark when it's off. It has good vivid screen colors and good brightness, but I must admit that the resolution is not the best and far from the original Note 4 with 2K display. Also, we find a nice CNC alloy frame and pretty nice touch buttons with backlight. Also, it's nice to see that it has both things, so we both have buttons with backlight and a multicolor notification LED. So regarding the cons, it's not the cheapest, and in my opinion it should be priced lower, and it's not a real one-to-one clone. For some people this could be a minus. The overall build quality could in my opinion be much better. It does have a metal frame, but it doesn't feel premium in the hand, especially the back cover feels kind of cheap. Also, the battery is not the best. It is possible to go through one day with the phone, and I didn't experience any serious battery drain when it was in standby mode, but don't expect super battery life. The phone does have a lot of fake options, especially in the quick toggles. It shows, for example, NFC, and because it is not a one-to-one clone, you can't use the original battery covers or accessories from the Note 4, so that's also a downside. So that's it for the review. Remember also to check out my blog. You find the link in the video description. If you think I forgot something or have any questions, please comment below, give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more. Thanks for watching. See ya.